Hello everyone, you're welcome back to Netcode-Hub channel. This channel, we learn a lot of .NET lessons, which comprise of Blazor WebAssembly, Blazor Server App, and also .NET MAUI application. This video, we're going to talk about how to upload image to Web API. Many people have been wondering on how to do that. And in this video, I'm going to cover that with you. So, without much ado, let's start. What we need to do here is we have to create a blank solution. We're going to add an API. Also, we're going to add a MAUI application. So, we're going to have one solution and two projects. We're going to create our API first, and we're going to create our that is a MAUI application. Then we're going to try to connect these things together to make it work. So let's start. So I'm just going to create a blank solution. I click on the file, then new, or click on this new project, and I'm going to search for blank solution. Now, when I'm done with this, I'm going to put this to GitHub so you can just go in there and unclone it and review. And I'm going to give the name as demo file upload. So demo web API, but I want to add MAUI web API file upload. And that's the location. So create. And I have my solution created. So that's your project. Now, aside from that, we're going to add some sort of project to it. So when you go to Solution Explorer, we have this solution. Now, within this, I'm going to add a new project. And this project, I'm going to add the first API. So I have the ASP.NET Core Web API. If not, go for the Web API. And I cannot choose for this C# one. And here, I'm going to say this is a server. So there is a server API, server, and apps just add. So configure for HTTPS, I'll enable them and click on create. And you know, the framework version is here is .NET 7.0. That is what we are using. All right, so aside from this, we can also go in for, we can also add the client, and that's gonna be the mobile one. So let me add this. So I click on solution, then add a new project. And I'm going to be .NET MAUI app, or click on MAUI. And I'm going to have this. You're going to choose this, and we can say this is, let me say MAUI client, and add it. So the same framework, click on create. To get it created. So you see, we have one solution and now two projects, server and also the client. Now the server is set up as a startup project already. As you can see, it is what it is, bold, and that is it. Okay, so now we are done with this. Let's try to build this application and see if everything is working perfectly as expected. All right, so you can see that our projects have been built successfully. Now we want to focus on the server for now, so that's why you see it has been selected here. Let's go in there and let's click this to run the server and see what we have now. All right, so you can see that our server is working and we have it displayed in the Swagger. Now let's go to our application, and I'll in here. We are going to create a controller for the file upload. So we click open the server project, and at the controller folder, let's create one controller here, and let's name this as new controller. So let's stop this first. and it's supposed to be an API empty one, and I'm going to name it as file upload or upload files or files controller any. So upload file controller, and I'm going to click on OK. So in here, we have to specify some few things. We first have to inject some few components or few things here. Then we write our action method. Let's first create a constructor for this. So ctor. So in here, we have to inject iLogger. So we inject this iLogger controller, and that is the upload file controller. So that's the name of the controller here. Then we inject it into this controller. We initialize it over here. Also, we need iWeb host. So we have to also inject this iWeb host environment. And now we have this web host environment. So this is going to give us the access to our root application. Okay. We have to also initialize it over here. So now let's go in there and create an action method. And you know, this is going to be an HTTP post. So let's have action method like that as post. So HTTP post. So that is this one. All right. So the first thing what we do here after creating our HTTP post verb, we have to create our method, and that's an action result. And the method here name is what, post. So aside from that, we want to store the content that is coming in here, and we can get that from this HTTP context.request. That is the request coming in. Now with this, the next thing to do here is we want to check if the request is null. So if the request is null, they want to return bad request. But in case it is not null, then we want to check if the context contains multiple files. Okay, so if the count is more than zero, then this is what you want to do. You want to now loop through the files here. You want to loop through one by one. And on the specific file that we loop through or we have at hand, we are going to get the file path. So we can get the file path by combine this web host environment.content root path. And also we create a folder. You want to locate this folder. So images upload folder. And that is the folder we want to paste, or we want to just save the file in here. Now after doing that, we want to check if this folder exists. So if it doesn't exist, then create the folder here. Also, the next thing to do here is then after creating this file or creating this folder, we want to now create an instance of this memory stream, because you know all media that you upload or all images that you upload to HTTP context here has to get to the stream. And so you create an object, then here we're going to copy the file to this memory stream. That is the instance of this memory stream that we've created. Aside from that, then we are going to combine the path and to this memory stream. And the last part here is we are going to return. Okay, so we want to say that the number of items, the number of images that you selected, we converted the count to string, and I receive files what uploaded. So if it is a number of files that you upload, it's going to be files uploaded. So let's, you can decide to pass in so file or files uploaded. Now after doing this, the next thing to do here is we can return bad request in case we did not select any file, because here we are checking if the count is greater than zero. If not, return bad request. So let's pass it here. And on this bad request, you want to pass in no file selected. Okay. Now we have this. We want to put this in an exception. So let's put this in a try catch block so we can use this logger to log the information. So let's specify this try catch block on top here. So we try and catch, then we log the file and return this status code as 500 internal server error. So let's move this into the try catch block here. Yeah, so that is what you want to do. Let's make some change here before you run it. It's supposed to be file.filename. Not file.name, because you want to grab the extension of the file as well. So this file name is going to give us the extension as well. But when you use the name, it's going to grab only the name and exclude the extension. So let's make this. Then can I go ahead and I'll try this application or try this API and see if it is working. All right, so you can see that we have our method here, and that's the upload is wrong. Let's see. So upload, the method name is supposed to be. Oh, okay, the container name is wrong. You see ULP. What is it? All right, so then let's focus on this. You want to focus what the context of this. So now you have this. What you're going to do here is we can try this. Okay, but when trying this, we need to specify a file. So maybe we can use Fiddler or Postman to do that. Let's try before we use it or we do that in our Maui application. So let's try this out, and I'm going to try out and execute. So you can see we have this logger information, and it is saying that the status code is 500 and an error occurred while processing your request. So that is it. Now let's check our root and see if any folder is created or not. So right click on this and I'll go to open folder in file explorer and let's check it out and see. So we are not having any folder yet because an error occurred while trying to create it. All right, so let's now use a Fiddler to intercept with this and let's try to upload file. So let's go in there and let's grab this. So I want to grab, that is a URL request. Let's copy this, let's go to the Fiddler. And here, you can go to Composer, let's paste this over here. And now let's change this to post. Now here, upload file. So you can go in for this image, and that's the about image. So click on OK. We have this about image, as you can see, it is including this file. And now there's the root over here, that's the path. So let's click on execute. And there is a response over here, so we must see a response. When we click on this as a response, you can see we have one file uploaded. Okay, now this file, let's go to the application, and actually we have a folder created. As soon as you open it, you can see we have this file over here. If you go to the root folder, so right click on this, and I go to open file in folder or open folder in file explorer. You can see we have an image or a folder created, and that is the file here. So now this is working. Let's go in there and connect our mobile application to this API call for file upload. So I'll close everything from here. And now I want to let's launch this client first. So that's going to be our Maui app. So let's launch our Maui. So let's set this to startup project. Right click and go to set as startup. Before that, you have to close this. So before you close it, I want us to copy this URL. Okay, so it is here already. So let's see where it is. So we can go back to. And that is it, API. So we can put the URL somewhere. So I want to just grab this and now open notes. So I want to paste it here. All right, so now you can go ahead and stop this. And let's set this as a client, as a startup project. And defaultly, it is run on Windows. So we can just try this on Windows and see. All right, so now that our app is now ready, as you can see from here, we can also run this in the Android as well, okay? But for now, let's try with this. When we are done, going to run this on the Android and see the output as well. So now let's close this. And where we have this button, you can see we have this, the main page, for example. And I want to open this main page. As soon as this button is clicked, you want to now upload file. So here, you don't want to say click me, rather, so browse file. So let's say this is, okay, so browse file. So as soon as it is clicked, let's see, we go back to the code behind file, and that is this. And now here, we're going to code it here. So let's clear all this. Okay. So in here, what we need to do here is we can use file picker or media picker. File picker allows you to select any file at all. you want to focus on media, right? So that's the image. So I prefer we use this media picker. So to do that, you can just create a file as upload file is equal to, then gonna have new media picker. Okay, so as you can see, it's over here. Then we can use dot pick, so media picker dot, then with this we can have access to method. Now before that, here's supposed to be an await. So await, then as soon as I click on dot, you can see we can now have access to pick video, capture video, and do all these stuff. Okay, so let's use for pick photo async, because that's what you want to do. We want to pick photo here. And we have to make here as an async. So we can now have access to, we can check if this file upload or the data, the variable that we have stored for this results of this media picker or picking the photo is not null. If it is null, then we want to return. But in case it is not, then we want to create the multipart form data content and I'll add this file to the content. After adding it, we create an instance of this HTTP client, then we post the image or we post the file to the link that we copied. Remember that we copied the link and I paste it over here. So that's the link that we are adding and we are posting this file to. And we are going to read the response and now we're going to return this as an alert to the user. All right, so now let's save this and let's run this application. So it's almost run, so let's try to rebuild this. So now that it's ready, let's click on browse file and I'm going to choose a file for this. So let's say we choose this contact, click on open. Okay, so if I click on open, let's wait for the alert. You can see one file uploaded. There is a response from the server. Now let's go to our server and check the folder in it, or we can just navigate to the folder. You see we have the file over here as contact. When you go to our server, so listen to the explorer, you can see we have this image, you can see we have this contact.png added. Alright, so that will be the end of this video. So we've seen how to upload data, especially file, from our .NET MAUI application into our ASP.NET Core Web API. I'll make this configuration for this to enable on Android too as well. So when you clone this project and I run it, you can just try it on your Android device and I'll make the settings as well before I push it to the GitHub so it can work on the Android too. So subscribe to the channel because it's very important. Click on the like button if you think it is you like it, so it enables other people to also see this video as well. Don't forget to check the playlist because we have a lot of goodies for you. Alright, so thank you so much for watching this video and hopefully I'm going to catch you up in the next video.